Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. Welcome to Holy Rosary Parish and to our celebration of the Sacrament of Confirmation for the deanery. We welcome our young men and women from Our Lady of the Pines in West Yellowstone, Holy Rosary Parish here in Bozeman, and Resurrection University Parish here in Bozeman. And always a very special welcome to Bishop Better, our bishop, who will be presiding today. Welcome, Bishop Better.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
Peace be with you.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he decided to release him. You denied the Holy and Righteous One and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did, but God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, I know him, but do not keep his commandments, are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. After Emmaus, the two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." He said, as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy, and were amazed, he asked, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to the scriptures. He said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins should be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning with Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Please stand when your name is called. Elizabeth Becker. Claire Becker. Ollie Velasco. Emery Velasco. Tegan Biggs. Allison Boyd. Soren Brower. Cassian Fabris. Isabel Fabris. Maquetti Fabris. Jocelyn Fraser. Joseph Fraser. Diver Gellinger. Stefan Gustafson. Bronson Hall. Brooks Hall. Michael Heacock. Clayton Holman. Mira Horrigan. Parker Horrigan. Amelia Hunter. Josephine Yavin. Cade Yavin. Gabe Johns. Caroline Johns. Hudson Jones. Cooper Jones. Alina Magneto. Isaiah Matosik. Aiden Matosik. Amy Lynn McGoldrick. Kathleen Nancy. Ryan Nancy. Hazel Nash. Caitlin Payhut. Clara Payhut. Adam Travis. Lola Piazzo Smith. Matthew Rayberger. Evan Rayberger. Brianna Rodriguez. Alberto Rodriguez. John Santiglia. Jacqueline Santiglia. Molly Schott. Silas Scott. Sarah Solist. Amaya Sedura. Tariq Tasker. Cash Tasker. Andrew Tatarka. Andrew Turnquest. Noah Turnquest Lynn. Violet Turnquest Lynn. Isabel Van Tyne. Paul Van Tyne. Luke Vegan. Peter Warnock. Wilson Whitley. Brian Wilson. Soleil Arredondo, Isaac Vega, Jonathan Arredondo, Lucy Leishock, Rose Guerrero, Angel Resendiz Guerrero, Giselle Morales, Paloma Resendiz Guerrero, Anton Schultes, James Schultes, Isaiah Schultes, Melanie Salinas.
You can be seated. Thank you for wanting to be confirmed. A little word of encouragement to your families and sponsors. I beg you, during these next minutes, as we pray for a fresh outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon these young people, you know them better than they know themselves. So ask the Holy Spirit for what they need most in their lives, especially those areas they don't realize. Ask for it, and the Holy Spirit will not disappoint. I have a prayer and a hope for each of you young people from this point forward after confirmation, that you know deeply inside that none of you suffers alone. And that almost always when we suffer, it's not because we did something wrong. God's not punishing us. He's not abandoning us. I think, I've been your bishop now 4.5 years, if you'd ask me, what have I learned the most? I would say, what I've learned the most is that young people think if they do everything right, they won't have to suffer. And that if they do suffer, all the wheels come off and they don't know what to do. The Holy Spirit, one of the titles, is Comforter. The Holy Spirit is a comforter in our suffering. We're united to Jesus in baptism. Whatever happens to him happens to us. And guess what he just said in the first reading? Did you not know that I was to suffer? The apostles were shocked that he embraced suffering. And the reason Jesus embraced suffering was to give our suffering meaning. It's not pointless. We unite it with Jesus. So when you suffer, say, Holy Spirit, come. Jesus, help me. It hurts. That's my hope and prayer. That after today, you have a deeper sense and realization that you're not alone. And you're not suffering alone. And when we suffer, usually not because we did something wrong. And Jesus loves you, cares deeply for us, every one of us. Why am I here? Because Jesus is the one who's going to confirm you, but he picks me, a successor to the apostles, to show up so that you can see what I look like. And then you say to yourself, whatever I'm going to do for the rest of my life, I'm just going to make dang sure that the church I'm going to has one of those guys in it. A bishop. Because I know someone who knew someone who knew someone who knew someone who knew the apostles who knew Jesus Christ. That's who's confirming you today. God is coming so close, He's going to breathe on you. He's going to breathe in you. I hope you're not doing that to a lot of people. It's a pretty intimate thing. That's how close God comes to us when He comes to confirm your faith and to allow His life to grow and mature more and more within you. I'm proud of you kids. You know, I've been spending a lot of time with young people. One of the things, I was just with Carroll College teaching a class. I said, you know, a lot of people say you're worthless, but God doesn't, and I don't. You're worth a lot. In fact, you're worth Jesus being willing to be nailed to a cross. Someone died for you. That's what you mean to Him. So, let's not go any longer. We're hot, huh? But know my prayers for you. And I want you to know this. I tell them at Legendary Lodge, and I mean it. If you ever wake up one day and say, I don't know who to talk to. I don't know where to turn. You can go to any of them. But if you don't know where to turn and you are someplace and you don't know what to do, call me. Go to the Diocese of Helena and say, Bishop Vedder confirmed me 15 years ago. I don't know what to do. I'm sitting in prison. And I'll come visit you. I visit the prison. They like it when I visit. There's Catholics in prison. Did you know that? They end up there too. And they have as much dignity and worth as any of us. Always keep that in mind. You don't know where to turn. Hunt me down. And I'll help you. So, nice and quiet. Young people getting ready to be confirmed. What do you want from God? In your heart, you tell Him right now. Tell Him what you need, what you desire, what you hope for. And give Him your suffering now. Invite those to be confirmed to stand. And I'm going to ask you some questions. And I want to hear your answers. Okay? The answer is I do. Do you renounce Satan and all his works and empty promises? You believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? You believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? You believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who today, through the sacrament of confirmation, is given to you in a special way, just as He was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost? You believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Dearly beloved, let us pray to God, the Almighty Father, for these His beloved sons and daughters, already born again to eternal life in baptism, that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them to confirm them with his abundant gifts, and through his anointing, conform them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these your servants to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin, send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Who's first? Thank you, Jerome. Be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Thomas, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. Mary Magdalene, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.
Spirit. sealed the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Stenson. Neil Stenson, we sealed the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. And Bernard, we sealed the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Sealed to get the Holy
declare a saint to be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. St. Lucy, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Cecilia, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. David, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Thomas, sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Sebastian, sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Elizabeth Ann, sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with
I invite you all to stand for our petition.
For these, God's servants, whom the gift of the Holy Spirit has confirmed, that planted in faith and grounded in love, they may bear witness to Christ the Lord by their way of life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For their parents and sponsors, that by word and example they may continue to encourage those whom they have sponsored in the faith, to follow in the footsteps of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Holy Church of God, together with Francis our Pope, Austin Anthony our Bishop, and all the bishops, that, gathered by the Holy Spirit, the Church may grow and increase in unity of faith and love until the coming of the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the whole world, that all people who have one Maker and Father may acknowledge one another as brothers and sisters, without discrimination of race or nation, and with sincere hearts seek the kingdom of God, which is peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For vocations to priesthood, religious life, and marriage, that the Holy Spirit will continue to inspire and guide friends and family members to take up lives of ministry in the Church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, who gave the Holy Spirit to your apostles, and will that through them and their successors, the same Spirit be handed on to the rest of the faithful. Listen favorably to our prayer. Grant that your divine grace, which was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, may now spread through the hearts of those who believe in you, through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite you to be seated for the offertory.
Come with joy, a child of God.
Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exalted church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Truly
right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. Ascending above all the heavens and sitting at your right hand, he poured out the promised Holy Spirit on your adopted children. Therefore now and for all ages unending, with all the hosts of angels, we sing to you with our hearts, crying out as we acclaim. Fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all the clergy. Remember also, Lord, your servants whom you have been pleased to confirm today by the bestowing the Holy Spirit, and keep them in your grace. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit,
All glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with
offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Accompany with your blessing from this day forward, O Lord, those who have been anointed with the Holy Spirit and nourished by the sacrament of your Son, so that with all trials overcome, they may gladden your church by their holiness and through their works and their charity, foster her growth in the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Congratulations. Clap for them, huh? John Kowalski. Thank you. Clap for him, too. Clap for Fran, too. Where's Fran? And for your good pastors, huh? An hour and 5 minutes ain't too bad, huh? If you have the air conditioning fix out, I've been done in an hour and 8. I was only able to cut off 3 minutes. There's coffee or cookies reception downstairs. I'm going to process out, come right back up. If you want a photo, come right away. I'm hot. If you don't want one, it won't bother me one bit. But I'm more than happy to take some photos with you. Okay? Congratulations, young people. Say a prayer once in a while for your bishop, okay? And this year, Pope Francis has asked for a year of prayer. He wants all of us to pray more. So what does praying more look like? 4 minutes more a day. You don't have to start with adding an hour. 4 minutes. That's more. And watch what starts to happen. 4 minutes more of prayer will change us completely. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. And may he grant you peace. And may Almighty God bless all who are gathered here, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thank you.